Hey folks, Matt from RightOfTheImage.com. We've got a viewer writing in here. This is Patrick. The heading of this email is DSLR versus mirrorless. And that's probably a question that a lot of people have in their heads right now. And we're seeing all of the new mirrorless coming out. We're waiting on the Nikon full frame mirrorless announcements. And it's hard to decide what to do if you're looking to upgrade at the moment. He says, Matt, I've been seeing a lot of videos from you about the ongoing mirrorless revolution happening in photography. Here is where my question comes in at. I currently have two rather old DSLRs, a Canon 20D and a 7D. I have a good mix of lenses for them. The 70-200 f2.8, 24-70 2.8, 51.8, a Sigma 18-250, and a 70-300 macro and a 28-90 macro. I love my 7D for what I need. It works just fine. Only issue is I wish it was a little smaller and lighter for taking on trips, i.e. Disney, Las Vegas, etc., where I do a lot of walking and lugging. The 7D, even with just the 18-250, gets a bit old after a while. Was thinking of selling both bodies before they lose even more value and picking up either the Canon M5 or the M50 with the EFM to EF adapter. This way I can use the lens I have. What are your thoughts, Patrick? Well, thanks for your question, Patrick. It's an interesting question. I think I'm a little bit torn because you're used to a 7D, which was a higher performance, the top end of Canon's APS-C sensor DSLRs. On the other hand, it's getting old in the tooth, and there's not a lot about the 70 that the M50 probably can't do or beat. So even though I think you might be better off with whatever the next level of camera is, at the moment, I would agree with your assessment of selling both, and I would say to pick up the M50. It's the latest and greatest, the newest mirrorless from Canon at the moment. And the thing is, the M50's been on for some pretty crazy deals. I'll put a link below, as always. But you could pick up the M50 with a lens for it was on I think a couple hundred dollars off recently. May still be a very, very good deal. And if you could pick one up, a Canon refurb or a used one, or you get one of those deals, maybe just wait a little bit until you see that deal still go on. I think it was around 600 that body went down to, and I don't know. I think that was with the kit lens. And even if you don't want to use the kit lens, you could sell it and then recoup some money from your investment. That's the way I would go, because you're investing in that system for very little money. You're getting 4K. You're getting a very fast camera. You're getting a great little camera, small and light. It's certainly going to nail all those bases for your travel photography. You get the EF M adapter, and you can use all of your existing lenses. And it's kind of a win-win situation for you. And then if they come out with the next level, if you've got it at a good deal, if you purchase the M50 on sale, like one of those deals they've had on, you can liquidate it for not too much of a loss and step up to the next level, or keep it as your secondary body, which, you know, you're used to having two bodies to shoot with, it sounds like. That's what I would do. Let me throw it back to our viewers. What would you do? Do you agree with me on getting the M50? Do you think he shouldn't, simply because maybe the 70, you know, if you're used to shooting a 70, you might not be happy with the M50? I kind of think you would be. I think the smaller, lighter, and with all the advances of the M50, you'd be okay. Yeah, there's some caveats. It's not a full pro body or anything, but pretty nice camera. Or do you guys think he should go another route altogether? Let me know what you guys would do. Let's help out Patrick. Let us know in the comments below. What would you do and why in Patrick's situation here? Thanks for your question, Patrick. Stay tuned, folks. We'll be back soon here at ArtOfTheImage.com.